We got a call from a national film school saying, we've got this young student with us who's seen your work. Can you come up and talk to him about animation? And this was Nick Park, and was working on his student film, a small little film called Grand Day Out. And by that time, he'd shot not a lot of it. And we got to know him, and we realised there's a kind of kindred spirit. You could see from the footage that he'd done, a naturally very gifted animator, understanding of performance. And the school was helping a bit, but basically he was left to his own devices, so it's taken forever. And actually he came down, we said, look, come and help us do some morph work, which he did in the summer, and we paid him for that, helped him through. And we actually then helped him with his storyboard on Grand Day Out. We helped him edit that. As Channel 4 got going, helped to make a film called Babylon in the Sweet Disaster series, which was produced by a guy called David Hopkins for Channel 4, which is dealing with the sort of the nuclear holocaust sort of thing. It's quite heavy stuff, but this film was based around the arms dealing, annual conference of a bunch of arms dealers in their DJs, a big night out, and this sort of big political speech. And there are about 50 characters, and we thought, we can't possibly just animate those. We had Golly with us. So we thought, actually, I'll tell you what, let's get Nick in, you know, that lad we met, get him, he can help out. And we did a deal with the film school. He still hadn't finished this was 5 years into the film school. And we said, look, we'll help Nick finish him. If we can bring his camera down and his sets down, we'll help him finish if he can help us make this film Babylon. And that was about 1985. We said, by the way, we've got this series of films at Channel 4. You know, would you like to work on one of those? And Nick, you know, was very interested in animals and birds and wanted to do something around a zoo. And he selected to do this little film, Creature Comforts.
Was that part of the commission with Jeremy Isaacs?
That was part of the commission with Jeremy Isaacs, yes. By this time, he was also drawn to a close on Grand Day Out, because once he had joined us, by that time we had some model makers. I did quite a lot of his photography. We just helped him through it and gave him a more kind of structured approach to the whole thing. And we ended up putting it into the Oscars. So he had two out of three films in the Oscars, Grand Day Out and Creature Comforts, in 1989, yeah. Whenever it was. Yeah.
Sound running, when you're ready.
Oh, well, the zoos are very important to animals. They're a bit like homes, like nursing homes, and for poor animals and people like old people. And there's old animals which are dead, and people in the wild don't have much to eat, so they have to kill their own people to have something to eat.
Yeah, well, it's reasonably comfortable, I suppose, this place, but, I mean, I've been in more comfortable rooms, yes.
If you try to compare the situations and the environment that you live here with the environment that you live in Brazil, there is a big difference. Here, you live in a very small place, with all the technological advances possible. You have everything sorted out, double glazing, you know, your heating and everything in Brazil, but you don't have space. In Brazil, you have space, although you don't have all this technological, you know, double glazing and things like that, and you know, but you have space. And we need space to live. We need space to feel that we are part of the world and not a kind of piece of object in a box.
The interesting thing about Creature Comforts, which I'll never forget, again, Nick was one, he animated kind of straight through. He didn't use a lot of video playback. He just went for it. And he says, animating that jaguar, or that voice, because it was so expressive, not quite the easiest thing he's ever done, but it just flowed out of him. It was so natural. The expression was there. And I can remember, we had a very small cutting room at the back of this building, lacing up. We'd had obviously heard the mag track, lacing up the mag track, getting the rushes, because he didn't send off to the lads until, in fact, shot a whole chunk of stuff, so it's quite scary. And then kind of syncing it up and realizing this is absolute magic. It just went together so well. It was quite uncanny, and realizing this is, you know, what he's done here is something very, very special.
The impact of Creature Comforts was phenomenal.
It's kind of a breakthrough, partially because, you know, partially because what Channel 4 were doing was putting out animated films for more adult audience, of a different level, a different.
Well, it was taken away from the sort of the
children's bit,
into a sort of more grown up, more adult.
More adult. Yeah. And actually, what came out of the woodwork were a lot of extraordinary animators, you know, the Brothers Quay, Joanna Quinn, a whole Candy Guard, a whole bundle of a different mode of expression, in fact. And it kind of created this, well, like a kind of art form in a sense.
Yeah, yeah.
Completely different approach to what you could do with animation.
Yeah. I miss a lot of the food. I miss the fresh meat, you know, because in Brazil we are predominantly carnivores. We are not, you know, vegetarian. And we don't like potatoes, we like meat. And we like fresh meat.